pro from the Netherlands. You played Chantal Arthur.
That's correct. You added up top 32 here twice this moment.
Yeah.
Is there anything you want to see before we go to the decklist?
Yeah, the tournament went really well. I just fucked up the Peter Match in top 32. But...
Right. Yeah, it happens. Yeah, let's do this.
Alright, free map. And then two home again knights, because we play Burst Rebirth. So we want to open one of these. You always want to open when you go first. This.
Best card.
Then these three and one Beagle Tech. For the shadows we play a low count of shadows, because when we were testing, me and my team, every time we opened up like multiple shadows, it was really hard. And we lose most of the time, so 2 Falco, 2 Dragon, and just 2 Beast, and only 1 Headshot and 1 Skomada.
Right.
And it worked fine.
Yeah.
I never had a problem of not having a Beast or Headshot. These were really good with Beagle Tech and the Mole Tech, because sometimes you don't have your an opening play with Mathetician on again night, and any of these are good are in play when you start. So, and we didn't want to play MST, but this it does same as MST, but when you have like an MTS and something else, it becomes a +1.
Right.
So it also gets cards out of your deck. This is really good. Stupid cards. This. And then one double cyclone instead of the third ignition.
Yeah.
Because you can chain it on anything you activate, and the MTS and then you chain on whatever you do. Traps, bolts, 2 Burst Rebirth. It's mainly for if you go first. It's really good because Sinister and Falco is like a semi-auto win opening. But we wanted to have like another one, so this and this, when you send Beast, is also kind of the same semi-auto win opening. So that's why we played Burst Rebirth. I did side it out every time I didn't go first though.
Right.
2 Trapstone, they were amazing. Yeah. But now if Trapstone really gets more popular, I would change these for Y taps, so I can Y tap my bonus traps and and break 2 skills, because I play artifacts, best trap, and these are obvious, entry emptiness.
Of course. That was amazing.
Yeah, 41 cards.
40.
Yeah, that's the number.
Okay.
All right, extra.
Yeah.
Sure. 2 constructs. Yo, Michael, really good. Never made it. Made it once. This was amazing. This won me a game. This was really good. Against Satella, I dropped this twice and it was instantly game. You can negate everything. It's amazing.
Yeah.
And you can also, when you already search their Altair, you can reshuffle that Zion. Never made this, and made this once.
Right.
Play 2 Kai's, they're alright. I didn't play Monarch Stormfall because it didn't really work for me. But these were good. Play 1 Gorse, mainly for Satella Burning Abyss, because if you drop Gorse, they never free emptiness. They never do that before they attack or whatever. And to get rid of this, they need to go into the extra deck. So if you have an out for emptiness, you can fusion them and most time you win from that. 1 Fleece if I go 2nd. 1 MST. He wants to have like 1 more out for Floodgates.
Floodgates, yeah.
1 Defusion. Yeah, it's still good. Auto win and good fair card.
Of course.
I never drew these, but yeah, in testing they were good, I guess. These are amazing with the artifacts, and against Burning Abyss and Stella, if you hit them for like 2-3 traps, they can come back. Because they can get rid of your fusions without traps, obviously. These are for the artifact nomads. And yeah, Burning Abyss, but I never drew them.
Of course. Alright. Raphael, any last words?
Yeah, shout out to my team. and my teammates, of course, Flash and Tom van den Hoek, we built this deck together, we all played it. And our sponsor, Gamers Paradise, in the Netherlands.
Right, okay, yeah, Rafael. Thanks for the deck, Rafael, and congrats with your top 32 spot here at YSS.